Deztro the Eskimofo versus Jeff Christie. Now that's a cold open. Cold shot. Son of a...
Jeff Christie, you call yourself the head of security, and believe me, my man, I think you are nothing but muscle. I believe you are serious. You are legitimate. But I am the gate crasher. So you are there standing, trying to be the law and order in Big West. I am the ultimate rebel. I will defeat you on my way to the top in this round robin. I will not lose. I will be number one before we are done. This season of Big West. Whoo! It's time for the rise of the Eskimofo. And that starts by taking out the big dog at the gate. So, Mr. Christie, you, my friend, are not a snack. No, you are my entree. So this week, I get full. Bring it on, brother.
Tuesday night, TalkDown. Deztro the Eskimofo. It's your boy, Jeff Christie. You see, I'm out here in the wild area of British Columbia. It's got me thinking, you're one hell of a competitor. You're a strong one. You see, they say to be the best, you have to beat the best. And you, sir, you're one of the best I've ever seen. So that makes me think, what do I need to do to beat the Eskimofo? You know what? Get out where it's cold, because it inspires you. You see, I'm not scared of the cold, and I'm not scared of you, Deztro. You may be the best, but I'm going to be better, and I will be the new Big West Wrestling Internet Champion. We'll see you very soon, Deztro.
And some cold shots of truth. Casey Peake, you're pretty cocky for a guy who gets more L's than W. And Max Cage, that window of opportunity for you to show what you can do is closing really fast.
Tuesday night, TalkDown. It's your future internet champ, Casey Peake, back again. This week, my victim is none other than Max Cage. And you know what, Max Cage? I've decided to crouch down this week for a match. Get down to the new guy's level, the new kid on the block in Tuesday night, TalkDown. Make it a little bit more of an even match. That's not disrespect to you. I just want an even match, bro. That's all I want. But you know what? I've studied some of your work in the past couple weeks to talk down to start the season. It's not bad, I'll give you that. But is it going to be good enough to beat someone who's been around the block in Tuesday Night Talkdown? Who's had the chance to earn the respect of the fans already? Who's got a little bit of a following going to help him out with these matches? That's me, not you. So you know what? Let me leave you with some rhymes, Max Cage. Max Cage, Max Backstage. Max, I'm going to put you in your TalkDown grave this week. Because that's just what I do. With how my week is going, I have nothing to lose and everything to gain. So I'll see you on Tuesday night.
One, two, Max is coming for you. Three, four, better lock your door. 5, 6, get your crucifix. 7, 8, Casey came too late.
Peake. Late. Now, like I've said before in my debut, I've been watching and listening. And I've seen what you can do, and I will give credit where credit is due. But unfortunately, I cannot do that right now. But Max Cage, I have an idea. Give up, Casey. Put your tail between your legs and go back to just being ringside security. Because no matter how many times you cut a promo with no shirt on or in the bush or flexing your pipes, there's one thing you keep forgetting. It doesn't matter how much longer you've been in this game than me. It doesn't matter how many times you practice your speech. The only thing that matters is Max Cage is quicker than you. Max Cage is stronger than you. Max Cage is better than you in every single way. So thank you for being here, Casey. But I'll keep you in my review mirror.
Dylan Murphy last week thought this was a singing contest and Rick Jewell tried to make it a joke. Well, now they gotta talk it off. Talk it off.
The following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
Where, oh, where has Rick Jules gone? Oh, where can he be? Has he stretched himself too thin like he claims he has? Or is he actually afraid to face off against Dylan Murphy? You see, Mr. Jules, you can go off and do whatever you think needs done, and I will graciously and humbly accept this W, but I want you to know something. I am not through with you, Mr. Clown Prince of Chaos. You see, last week, you tried to take out that tiny little Robin. But what you're not understanding is that that tiny little Robin is the boy wonder of the DWO. And although your attempts failed at the attack of my boy Wonder, I take that to heart. Because when it comes to my family, Mr. Joker, I want you to come in and lean in very closely and listen. When it comes to my family, I'm Batman.
The World Order.
Sadly, you guys aren't getting my best this week. No fun edits, no jump cuts, nothing like that. But I'm going to give you the best that I've got with what I've got to work with. You see, right now, I'm in the middle of a real big move. And even though I apologize to the Tuesday Night Talkdown roster, after my DQ loss last week, there was no way in hell that I was going down without putting out some kind of a fight. So here I am going down swinging. Now, Dylan Murphy, from what I've seen so far, you are an outstanding competitor. You are a hell of an entertainer, and I'm really disappointed that I am not going to give you my absolute best this week. So you know what? I know I'm taking a loss here, so enjoy the win. Revel in it. Brag about it, because I would. And just know that the next time we get matched up together, that the result will not be the same.
Malik Melo's been on a tear through all of TalkDown this season. I don't know what's going to stop him. Will it be Dark Princess? Let's find out.
I've been thinking about this for a whole week now, 7 days. And call it a sneaking suspicion, call it a hunch, call it whatever. As I said back in the past last week, 30 years, mind you, I was thinking to myself, was this you, Princess? It had me so damn annoyed thinking to myself, we couldn't be sent back somewhere, you know, a bit more recent, somewhere where I was already born, but hey, personal gripe, maybe I'm tripping. Maybe you're not that kind of princess. Maybe you're not Wanda Maximoff. Maybe you're not Sabrina Spellman or all these other people. I will give you props, though, still. You joined the fray this season. We were going to square off eventually. But I still got to let it be known. Because unlike Hogwarts, unlike Westeros, all these other places we know about, dragon spells, black magic, voodoo, we don't see that around these parts. Because where I come from, my right and my left will handle my business just fine. So call me a non-believer. Call me whatever you please. These and this are rated E for everyone. Of course, you can prove me wrong. If you think I'm telling a lie, if I'm not being truthful, hey, take your magic wand, do something about it.
Nice to meet you. It's been a little chilly lately, and that's me, the Dark Prince. princess. Pretty angry. Pretty angry that it's cold. I don't like cold. But I can be cold. And you're massive. I may have to be a little bit more sneaky to hurt you, to destroy you. But they always say, the bigger you are, the harder you fall. I will make sure that is one hard fall. I will make sure that just like a tower that stands has a beautiful foundation, but the taller it gets, the more flimsy it gets. I will make sure that I knock you down like a tower. Because you're my way of stardom, of getting the internet championship. So you must go now. Toodles.
A rivalry that, well, almost rivals ours. Sleazy Steve, Justin Cider. One of the few to beat you, Justin. But never for the title, Steve. I'm gonna say it. Match of the night right here. Said it.
Justin Cider, we've been here before. We'll be here again. But I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to do to you because honestly, I don't care. Alright? I'm not going to tell you I'm going to beat you up. Well, this whole roster of internet marks who want to play wrestler are going to watch along. I mean, that's only our audience now, right? If you want to talk to me, you know where to find me. See ya, Cider.
Family!
Hey, what's going on?
Trying to think what to do with this promo this week, TalkDown.
You're stressing way too much about it.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Well, it's TalkDown. They don't want wrestling. They want acting, theater, Shakespeare.
I've been giving them damn Shakespeare for 3 seasons.
Yeah.
Last week we cut the best damn promo and the funniest damn promo. We got 3 best promo cutters there are on the damn freaking business here.
Shucks.
I don't get a draw.
The problem is, it's... You can't go talking quantum physics to third graders. You gotta get them something they want. Something they're familiar with. You don't... They want pizza. You made them the best damn chicken dinner ever. You could have given them the crappiest pizza and they would have been happy with that crappy pizza instead of your fantastic chicken dinner. You got this, buddy.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. I should have some passion for this. I'm spacing Sleazy Steve this week. You know, this passion's just not there. The fire's just not there.
Well, you guys remember that passion. You had it when you actually fought. Find that again.
Yeah.
Find that drive.
You know what? You know what? I got an idea. I'm going to go back to square one and go, I think I know how to make these guys happy. I got it. I'm going to go back to square one. I got it. Oh, yeah. That's how you do Tuesday Night Talk Down. Lucky jacket, terrible camera angle in the bathroom. That's a win, baby. I got this one in the bag. Boom! Nailed it.
Chucky Lee Ray, big boy from Big West. He's got lots of wins up there, but hasn't really transferred over to the Talk Down universe. Now Mean Machine Senior. Wow. Every week, I become a bigger and bigger fan of Mean Machine Senior. I wish you all the best, Chucky LeRae. I mean, you got a belt. You got your own belt. That's cool. But Mean Machine Senior. Wow. Cold shot.
Mean Machine Senior. It's been a while since we met. Now I've been on the bottom my whole entire life. But now I'm going to rise to the top once I beat you. It's exactly what's going to happen. They don't call me the ultimate underdog for a reason. I make comebacks happen. That's exactly what's going to happen. I'm going to rise up to the top. And that way everybody will know who Chucky Lee Ray really is.
Oh, hey.
Speed Machine Senior here, washing the dishes, keeping the house clean. Cleanest house, cleanest dishes. Running out of dish soap, just like Chucky Lee Ray. You're running out of time to prove yourself. You ain't proved nothing. Sure, you can win a title in a rumble. Sure, you can win a tag match when you got some goofball backing you up. But you know what? Can you win on TalkDown? I don't think so, kid. You can't do it. So when I'm done washing these dishes, I'm gonna mop the floor with you, Chucky Lee Ray, because you're a number 15 and I'm a perfect 10. Soon to be number one with a bullet.
Johnny Dean. Just love saying your name, Johnny Dean, Johnny Dean. You've been around for a while, but you haven't quite made a splash. Advocate, you've come so close and you've never won the big one. Maybe you can host next season.
Wow. 10th to last place. Last. Johnny Dean's a nice guy. You know, I guess that makes sense. Nice guys finish last, right? But I've never really understood that expression. Here's Johnny with a beautiful wife, beautiful car, beautiful home, good family, good friends, good job. Doesn't really seem like I'd be in last place. Oh, wait, no. I don't have the hot model trophy wife or the fancy Ferrari sitting in the garage. You know what kind of guy you gotta be to get that. I'm not swearing everywhere I go, giving those middle fingers. I'm not, you know, kicking the guy's ass that I accidentally bump into on the street. I get it. I'm not raising my voice. I'm not giving those passionate speeches like a Mel Gibson in Braveheart. I get it now. That makes sense. Well, maybe Johnny Dean needs an advocate. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe I can't do the talking anymore. Maybe I shouldn't do talking anymore and give the advocate that job. We have one here in TalkDown, don't we? Yeah. But the only problem with that is he's a nice guy, too. Guess I'm screwed.
The following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
Justin Cider brought passion. Jules brought jokes. And Johnny, I expect nothing different from you. Anybody else can tell me that this is an easy win for me. Anyone else can tell me, looking at the statistics, this should be one of my easiest matches, but I don't believe that. Because Johnny, I've always seen you as a genuine threat to me. I treat every competition like it could be my final, and Johnny, you're no different. You have intensity. You have veracity. And you can bring it anytime you choose to, but your lack of consistency with it is what has cost you. It is the reason you are in the position you are in, and you have to fight from underneath to come back. Believe me, Johnny, you're going to have easier matchups after me, but you're going to have to get through me first. I believe in you. Do you believe in you is the real question. Do these fans believe in you? You're the man of Greece. But even though Greece is ignitable, it's going to be me that has to light that fire. Do not stray.
Number one, 3 weeks in a row. Unstoppable. Got the whole roster seeing red. DeNero. But he's going up against Blu Wilder. A man who gets better every week and I am a personal fan of. Will he be able to topple the TalkDown Titan?
Red DeNero. You're a pretty good damn talker, Red DeNero. Last time you went against Blu Wilder, you did a history lessons versus Red versus Blu. Now I know, and I know, Cold Shot is here. And when every time I hear your name, Red DeNero, nowadays, I hear red, little DeNero. And trust me, Red DeNero, Blu Wilder is catching fire, catching it. Everybody knows it, you and I know it. So, Red DeNero, are you going to talk about the blue wrestler from the Arctic Circle? Or are you going to do another teacher lesson? And trust me, Red DeNero, cold shot, right? Peace be with you, Red DeNero. You're gonna need it.
Tuesday Night Talkdown, what it do? Are you ready for Red versus Blue, part two? I hope you are. Now, Blue, the outcome is gonna be the exact same as last season. Red is the better color and the better promo. You know it, everybody knows it. But Blue, I have to give it to you. You have stepped your game up. You are on another level. You are way better than the Blu Wilder of last season. But you're still not good enough, Blu. No. And I understand that you have kind of a new gimmick going on. You got the crazy eyes. But what you don't know is I am one of the craziest mofos going around. And my eyes may be beautiful and baby blue, but when I get angry, they turn red like that. And I see nothing but red. So Blue, I suggest you don't get on my bad side. You don't want to see when a ginger snaps. And it happens. Trust me, Blue, it happens. Once in a blue moon. But it will come out. Now don't try to mess with me, Blue. Red is always superior.
Another 8 battles this week, fans. Please choose a winner or a draw for all 8 matches, as well as promo of the week and match of the week. You have until Wednesday, February 24th at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time to get your completed ballots to us, either by replying on the Big West Facebook page or in this episode's YouTube comments. Do not go unheard this season, fans. Your competitors are counting on you.
All right, tonight's matchup, we've got
Eli Surge and Haviko
going up against
the Voros twins.
Boy, howdy, I'll never forget that one. That was a fantastic matchup. Whew, had me on the edge of my seat for the whole time. Enjoy.
Summerland. I told you I'd be back. Who am I? Haviko. I plan to continue making my name for myself in Big West Wrestling on October 25th, Stunday. I got the perfect opportunity. Haviko gets the chance to step in the ring with the Voros twins. Wait, twins? That means there's two of them. But there's only one of me, and I need two of me, but if there's only one Haviko, well, okay, I'm not the numbers guy, but you know who is? My tag team partner and good friend, Eli Surge. This gives me one heck of a competition. 4 young guys, all with something to prove, but I think we got the advantage on this one, boys. I'm sorry, see, you guys are great. You've done amazing things in this Pacific Northwest and starting to all around the world, to be honest, but you've always had this advantage. It's a thing called twin magic. I don't know if you know this, but magic doesn't work against tinfoil. So TikTok, boys, because when I hook up that kill switch, it doesn't matter which one of you I hit. Your moment's up.
Take her now to ringside.
Spanish, what's going on?
I figured out.
What?
Where are you shooting?
Gotcha! Yeah. thing, and that's a ghost rat, baby. Yeah, that's a thing.
Will you stop?